Hey folks, this is Njobl Ulram-blr with another episode of Rambling Skyrim with Njobl Ulram-blr. And we're outside of Dragon Reach to turn in that last bounty. Pretty much everything's done over there with the stores and the blacksmith and all that. We're ready to go do something new. And I'm thinking, rather than grabbing a new bounty, let's head out and take out that troll cave. And maybe move back into kind of the area where we began. Let's see, I'm looking for the steward. That's the Jarl. There. Hello.
Preventus.
I serve Jarl Balgruuf as steward. To do more for
the war effort. I interrupted something. He's going to talk the whole time. Anyway. Let's just click this one and get this over.
You've done us a great service. Here is your reward.
All right. Thank you much.
Enjoy your visit to Dragon's Reach.
You can have them now. Anyway, that's all I needed to do. Let's get out the door. And do I get a few more arrows or not? We may not be coming back to Whiterun. Let's go ahead and grab the rest of the orc arrows that our money can buy or something like that. Got, what was it? 600 some carry weight, 635. So we can stay out there for quite a long time and hit Riften or.
Mister, could you spare a coin?
Sure, if you'll stay long enough for
just
me to answer.
One gold, please. Oh, thank you. Divines, bless your kind heart.
So she is someone that you can adopt once you've got a home. And you can assign them to go to a home in any of the cities you actually have a home in. So it don't have to be here at Bree's home to adopt the orphan in this town. Though I'm curious, since this is an alternate start, it seems like the requirements to qualify for Bree's home had to do with the dragon quest, the dragonborn scenario. I wonder if there's a way to still get Bree's home otherwise, or do you have to become the Dragonborn? Don't know. Now, I wonder if the Khajiit traders are here by now. They're here every 3 or 4 days. Ah, there they are. Oh, I didn't get my arrows. Talked about it, walked right past them. Well, let's go see what they've got. These guys just roam around, set up tents, different places. You find them on the road too, walking from town to town. We can trade for them there.
Warm sands, friend. How may this one serve you?
Now, I wish I could get down and crouch to be down at his eye level. That's what I would naturally do, but to do so, I end up trying to pickpocket him. And that goes really wrong. So all the rest of these will attack you too.
Take a look.
All right, so what have you got available? I have 432 gold. Orcish Bow of Burning and War Axe. No arrows on you. Well, we do have quite a few. 81 and 50 steel. Yeah, we'll make this work. What do we have in the way of soul gems? 4 petties, 1 lesser. What do you have? You tend to have those sort of things. Do you have a common? You do. Let's grab one common. Let's grab another lesser. Yeah. Yeah. We could get it already filled, but we've got the bow to do that ourselves. And a few more petties might be nice. You don't have any. Oh, right there. Petty soul gems. Let's grab all 3 of these. Okay. So we'll fill all those up while we go. And I think that's all we're going to do. I've got nothing else to sell.
May your road lead you to warm sands.
Thank you.
Goods and wares of all kinds.
Where to? We're going out this way. Did we pick another route? The thought was to head back down to here, the troll cave. And then maybe even uttering There's two T's in there. Uttering Hills Cave, that quest we were given from the Lady at Darkwater Crossing. So we have two things unfinished. Might be wise to clean those up before we get into anything new. Kind of like that. Now, I can fast travel to any of these, right? Yeah. Might not be too dangerous to go to this one. That's the one we've cleared out the most recently. Quite often, a day or two after you clean one out, you fast travel to it, and there's already somebody standing there with a sword saying, "Hey, who are you?" And they suddenly start attacking. If you fast travel, we're kind of right to the front door. So it's a little worrisome to, fast travel on back out to this one after several days after we've dealt with it. Let's do that. We've walked this several times now. Let's not waste another half hour getting there. So we'll go ahead and do it this time. Though I should have done it with my sword out. Kind of wise to be ready to go as soon as you arrive. So we arrive, hit the control to drop into a crouch, and click the mouse button to drop into a weapon. Define, that's a deer. Define a bear, walking down the road here. Who knows what? I thought I saw someone standing there. Nobody there. Now, when we first came up through here, that first or second episode, probably second episode, we shot somebody off of this bridge. Never found that body again. I see I have... Let's see. What am I doing wrong here? That's what I'm doing. Okay. So the walk is correct. We didn't find them on the bridge. And unless... I don't know how long before a body despawns in the game. If it hit the water, it would have been probably stuck on a rock over here as far as looting. Would have been an archer, I'm thinking. But I think I would have noticed that last time we were here. So that's probably a done deal. That other body was here, right? And that's gone. So, despawned already. Game's cleaned it up. Okay. So we are on our own now. And it has been a few days since we've gone beyond, right about here. So any number of animals could now re-trigger, afresh. So it's kind of like walking this for the first time again. So is my guess. How are my volumes? I've been editing episodes and watching other things. So I think it's about where I usually set it. I don't like the echo I've been getting in some of the videos for the conversations. So I turn it down so my mic can't pick up out of my speakers. It doesn't seem to pick up any of the other noises. It just picks up the voices. Like it's just tuned to grab voices. Which is a good thing. It's supposed to be. But I don't want to grab a voice twice and get an echo. We seem to be pretty calm over here. I wonder if that fox is still swimming the little lagoon over here. I guess it's a river. I'm going to go ahead and swim this one. Oh! It wasn't much of a jump and leap to the other side. It was a drop in. Alright, we left her and the hint. The troll skull. And kind of a mooring right here, huh? What would this have been for? Would a serious, not ship, but a big boat, tiny ship or a big boat, be able to come in over here? No, this wouldn't be any kind of a dock for that, because one of these would need to be gone. So I wonder what this structure was intended for. The backyard deck. Yeah, that's what it is. And this is where I'm going to step on bones and break my own bones throughout the whole thing, huh? Alright, let's pull this out. This is our number 4? No, here's our number 4. And we should have orc arrows already triggered, right? We do. Okay. All right, let's walk in and see what we got. Okay. Nothing right here, so let's walk speed a little quicker. More turn. There he is. Now he's got quite a hit, but I am whittling him down. Oh, he's quick. Turn that off. Keep going up here. Hit seven a couple times. Oh, I didn't mean to go all the way out. I wanted to turn around right then. Don't think he can follow. I was going to turn around right there. Darn, that's a problem, because he is going to be right at the opening when I come back in. Let's find out. He's not. Let's make use of some supplies. Food. Let's grab that bowl of vegetable soup, and been saving things like the corned beef for just a situation like this, and this one right here. So that just about brings us back. Let's go finish him off and see if there's a second or even a third one hiding in here. Oh, I'm not sneaking. Where'd you go? And how much of your health did you already gain back? All of it. Great. Another turn coming up here. Bow bash. Where's my turn? Oh, where am I? There I am. Can I bash you? Oh, so close. Why did he back off? You're going to get back up, aren't you? Yeah. You're thinking about it. But you're not going to be nice this time either, are you? Ah, I don't want to wait. Alright, you're gone. Still, this bow doesn't do a whole lot of damage against something like this. Troll fat's all we're gonna get. None of my arrows, huh? Darn. Now, I don't know that we're alone. The original one we saw was over here. I have no idea if he's still there, and another one was pacing back and forth across the entrance. If I can get enough distance, I can get enough arrows in him before he closes the distance, if there is a second one. In there. So, we had folks living in here. Four sleeping bags there, sleeping spots. We've got access to sunlight in here, which is interesting. What are all you? Nothing? Okay. Which is going to show us off if we walk through that. Anything else in the cave. More sunlight over there. And yet, if you go over the hill to look for these holes, you'll never find them. Now, I'm not going to do any looting right now. But apparently they were living in here. Something took over. More bodies. Doubt there's much in them now. Just clothing. So we're clear here. Nothing down this pathway? Not that one can see. I'm hearing him. He's like over here. This must go around a curve and come back. I saw something. What are you? You're for armor. I'll take that. Well, just in case this lets out somewhere else. and I never come back to here again. Let's go ahead and get this place emptied. Not the skull. Great. Nobody walking up here. And skull, we've got elk hide over here. Skip the shoes. And we got that one. Okay. It's all for right here? Yeah. Anything in the bushes? Quite often you'll find a chest or something off to the side. She only had her clothing. That is an empty sack. Ah, knapsack full of stuff. And we'll just selectively deal with these. Yes and yes. Okay. What are you? Saying there's an iron sword right there. Search sack, yes, and you. You're a sack of flour. Okay. We'll go back to there. Let's run the perimeter. Okay, we'll check that out last up there. Take you. You are a fur helmet. Boy, it's a bloody mess over here. Knock the shoes right off of somebody. Iron mace. Well, that wasn't much of a jump. There's something. Bracers. And spiders. Ooh, I wonder if that's a sign of something to come. A strong box. Didn't even notice that. Garnet gold and a silver amethyst ring. Yep. Alright, anything else that I missed in here? I don't think so. So let's see if there's anything up here. Oh, that's part of a... What is the metal, though, behind it? Oh, that's something that you mount on the wall. Okay, I get it. It's decor. Now up here, more spider webs. Not seeing any traps or anything. That's a really smooth rock. That is nothing. A lantern. There's a little bit of stuffs up here. You are a shovel. Grab those. Nothing hiding in the trees. No. Okay. No other upper level items. No, I think we're clear here. Okay. So, bow, jump, drop, really. Ah, you can't maintain your bow when you drop. Interesting. Now here's where I've got the really strong urge to hit the quick save. As if I die, I'm going back. But that's just habit. I've spent many years tapping that F5 over and over. Take you. There you are. My escape route is that way. No, get back here. Oh, I wanted that shot. Okay. How long is your circuit? Is that my only chance for the next 2 minutes? Probably best that I didn't take that shot. I got a chance to see if he has any buddies. Shoot one and five red dots show up. That's a bad sign. He saw me. Okay. Get over here, get hidden again. Maybe I can get some more two times the. I don't know where I'm at. I want to be over here. Bad place to get turned around and cornered. I want to be over here. Okay. But we're clear. Alright, so it's that way and over there.
Mm-hmm.
He's fully regenerated his health. Wow. It's as if we never even took a shot. So as far back as I can, so he doesn't see me. Oh, I missed. Okay, I'm getting up here. Oh, come on, jump. Where is he? Give me a shot. Maybe he's not too smart. That would work to my advantage. He's fleeing? That's interesting. Any more red dots? No. There you are. Come on back before you regenerate. Oh, man. He's smarter than I gave him credit for, isn't he? Oh, for that grenade I was hoping for the other day. He's gonna completely regenerate. Okay. Let's get a poison on an arrow. Weak poison, stamina poison, lingering stamina poison. Let's go that route. I don't know if you can stack poisons. Okay. You're healed. Are you coming back? Do I really have to go chase you? Will he stay if I move on? There's a thought, though I'd always be looking over my back, over my shoulder. When I do that, he's triggered to go back in there. That's really interesting. That him? That's him. Okay, keep him in this insight long enough. Where are you? Where are you? No, 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 no. We're not gonna let you regenerate. Where am I? I'm not backing up. Alright, halfway there. Oh, bad move. He doesn't like this ramp. But these arrows are barely taking him down fast enough before he regenerates. I'll get my archery skills up, huh? There we go. Oh, that took a lot of arrows. Which means either he has a lot of skill points or I'm just shooting little baby shots. But I see that our bow is, let's see here, items, weapons. Bow of Scorching is almost out of power. Oh, I could have been finishing these guys off with the other bow. Darn. Forgot all about that. I don't know if I have enough in this bow to take out another one. That was a miscalculation on my part. Arrows back? Of course not. And all the other ones have been absorbed, I see. Who is this guy? Interesting. Okay, well, I could go out down a wolf or two and load up some of the petty soul gems and recharge the bow and come back in. What time is it? Cannot while enemies are here. I just want to see the time. I don't want to actually sleep. Okay, well, it's still registering this as full of enemies. Okay, I'm going to head out and see if it's possible to fill a soul gem. Where would I go for that? Oh, getting later than I thought. Time? 8 p.m. What time do the vampires come out? Are they like a midnight thing? There's a sheep. There we go. That will do it. So 3. I should have been on sneak, huh? Yeah. Let's cut him off over here. Ah, he went up that way. You are scuba goating. There you are. Alright. That will suck his life force into this petty soul gem. And then we can head over to our bow, Scorching, and hit T down there and charge a petty into it. Yes. And it just improved that much. Darn. Boy, I wish I could have caught those trolls. That would have been good. Although they may not have fit. They may be a level above the lesser. We only have lesser and petties. Let's go for one more. He's right there, I believe. No, that may not be him. It is. Oh! Ouch. I didn't collect the... he's going to go down river, isn't he? I didn't collect the hide from that last one. Let's collect his before he washes away. Okay. And let's go... No point in wasting. Don't kill it for the fun of killing. So we'll go grab the hide and all that off of this one. Which was where? Right here. Okay. Well, that should give us enough to pull out another troll. As far as the Imperial Bow of Burning. Okay, so... Weapon. That guy? That guy. Right there. Teep. And we will use this one. So we are up to about the halfway point now. Alright, so back to 4. There we go. How many arrows? Down 29 arrows. Ouch. Boy, we should have got more. I had no idea it'd take this many to take down a troll. R. And I think most of that is because they regenerate. So, I'll shoot him, he'll go down a certain amount, and he's gained back half of that by the time I shoot him again. So, and then when I didn't follow up and finish the job, he completely regenerated. Kind of wasted a lot of arrows that way. Anybody else in here? I see what killed the settlers, that's for sure. But this couldn't be all of them. And I'm still worried about those spider webs. I think that is a hint right there that we have got something ahead of us here. I'm just thinking there could be a troll standing right there, and if he's, you know, not moving, I could completely have missed him. That looks like a spiderweb covered roof there. Troll. Okay. Otherwise, is there a way? There he is. What's up here? Nothing. Okay. So this troll is going to take out the last of our orc arrows. Is he the only one? Where is he going? He's going up there. That's to our advantage. We take him right there. He's got to run all the way down, all the way back. That's a lot of shots available. Anybody else in this room? Potentially, yes. Getting close to level 9. Let's let him, hopefully not too long, but let him repeat his circuit. We'll take him right there. And then turn around so I can move. There you go. Then it's this way, straight across and to the right. That gets me out. Okay. You want to know your escape route before you do something as stupid as shoot an arrow into a troll. No, this isn't wise. Okay, next arrow. Got him again. As soon as he turns. Oh, he dodged. One more. Oh, darn it. I was hoping that it would take him down to a little red point. Then I'd get the other bow out. Okay, I missed that opportunity as well. Is this place? So those hello Nords that we're trying to live in here, we don't want to shoot from up here where we'll be cornered. Well, no, I can drop off there. Well, that might still work. They apparently inhabited the front of the cave and didn't realize that there was more. Just one. Paths into something else. What is this? We got him to take care of. Where is he? Right there. Where does this go? That's a root. A goat. This is the troll's home lair. Body. Treasure chest. I am alone, right? Goat, thank you. No traps. A bandit. Bandits try to live in here too. They lost. Lots of bones. A novice treasure chest. Well, I'll call it a treasure chest, but it's just a chest. Alright, what we got? We're hitting. There it is. We're hitting. Right there. Gold. Potion of Magicka. Hide armor. I'll take all that. That didn't trigger him to come running up here, did it? No, it didn't. Now, if I were to dive off of here, I could do that. Let's take him. But this time, I'm going to try to time it better so I can use the other bow. Ah, he stopped. Okay, one more of this bow. Okay, three. Now this one only does half the damage. Where are you going to turn to? You turned that way. Come on, fire. Ah, and dive off. Come on, pull it. Okay. Only half the damage. Ah, here it is. Okay. So he is a lesser? I would not have guessed that. As hard as it was to take him down. Miscellaneous. A lesser. Oh, I do have a common. So I could have gone into there. Okay. Is that how that works? Or will a bigger one go into a smaller, just part of it? I don't remember. Been too long. Anyway, let's use it. Weapons, we want this guy recharged. So T, this one will take it from there to there. So that's almost there. Then if we can get another petty, that will pretty much top us off. Okay. Arrows, I'm afraid to look. 11. Then we're going back to steel. I think it'll automatically drop down and reload the next arrows. Maybe we'll find some loot somewhere. It'll have arrows in it. Empty. No, that's not the one we just got. There's an arrow. Good. 12. And are you going to give us back an arrow? You are not. Alright, so 12 arrows. Switch back to 4. Got our best bow. There's another axe. No real need for that. Anything hiding in here that I would never have thought of? I just like to peek under the water. Sometimes there's a box or a chest or something in there. Okay, we do have an upper level here. Something was living here. This might be the bandits. At upper level. How do I get there? Kind of can't. Yeah, we'll do it this way. Probably get there from the other end of this. I wanted to see if there was something right over here. No. Waterfall coming off of there. And a space behind. Cart. And this might be where that bandit was living. Okay. Nice. We got his journal here by chance? No, but we have Orsinium and the Orcs. That's interesting. Gives us a heavy armor and a level up. I am wondering if this is someone who was studying the Orcs. I'll let you guys just pause and read if you want to. This might be something I should do in the series from now on, or at least maybe next round if we do this again. You guys can pause if you want to read them. And in between page turns. You can see this is long enough where I wouldn't be able to read it here. Take it? Yeah, it'll sell. Baskets. Gold. Okay. That's where we're going. Let's get there this way. Ah, another bandit. And his minor stamina. And a trap. Yep, I'll grab all of that. Nothing there. Alright, we've not been on this side over there. There's a troll. Got another one. Darn. A dagger. Nothing in there that I would want. Anything else up here? Like another troll that I wasn't expecting. Now we came in right there. Okay. Got an upper level up there too. Kind of doubt there'd be anything there. But I have completely missed treasures before. No. Alright. Escape pathway is over to there and turn. Going in here. Was it here? It was here. Right there. Right there in the glow of the light. Is it just the one? Is That's what I need to know. What are you? You're a rock, right? You're a rock. Okay. So let's let him get to the top of his path again. Is he gonna go back into view? I hear him. He's right behind me there. Behind that rock. There he goes. Alright. That is 4, correct? Correct. Eleven. 10. Oh, he didn't walk forward. 9. Oh, lost another one. Thought about resetting that trap. Where am I going? I'm going this way. Oh, there he is. But I don't know the bow bash is going to do much good there. Let's back up some more. He, meanwhile, is regenerating his health. Trying to back up. Okay, give me 3. Trapped him, but what did I trap him in? Probably the common. Though that's probably fine. We're only going to get the power of a lesser in a common. Why did my screen just go away? That was interesting. My screen just went black. My computer's freaking out over that troll. Let's see what we got. So, the common is still there. Did I have 2 lessers? I may have had 2 lessers. That's probably what it was. Now, do we want to use it yet? Or do we want to save it? I were to T now. Oh, there's still a little gap left, so I'm not wasting any. Let's do that. All right. And I'm on still orcs? Nope, I'm on irons. No, we're not on iron. Inventory, let's switch over to weapons. To steel. Okay. 51 arrows left. Hang on to the iron, even though I don't intend on ever using them as my emergency backup plan. When things go way wrong, and I never would have believed I would have burned through 81 arrows. Alright. Let's go back to sneak. I'm hoping this is the last one. But I've been surprised before. What are you? Your mammoth skull. Teeth. Interesting. Does anything down here look like it's salvageable? What a mess. What a boneyard. No humans, although that could be. Let's see if there's any clothing or remains. Otherwise, there's a deer. Get something out of that. There's a recent one. There's a person. Alright. Elk, venison, antler, red guard, just low level clothing. Another one there. And then where he probably lives up there. Dark elf. No. Though I'm guessing that's actually where he lives right there. That's why the mess. Treasure chest. Arrow. Is that an orc? It's an orc, but there's no point sending it because it's the only one. And I don't want this bow. 4. Oh, what a gruesome mess. Chest, no traps, no lock. Iron boots that resist frost. That's kind of like what we saw a day or two ago. Orcish bow at one of the traders. Gold lockpicks. All right, let's take a peek at that. Is that something we want to put on? Apparel. Boots. Weight 2, armor 10. Armor 11. Let's do it. Now, because it's already got an enchantment, it's not something that that I can upgrade. That I can upgrade now. You eventually could. I believe at the top end of smithing, you can upgrade enchanted items. Okay. Which one are we actually using? 22? Oh, that's something different. Okay. This is the shield. All right. So, let's figure out where we're going next. I wonder if this is a way out. We're kind of done. Kind of looks that way. Though I'm still wondering if there's spiders coming. No, that looks like a way out of Skyrim. Oh, fork in the road? No, just kind of a last. No, we're going into the cavern. What's in here? This drops us into our original one, doesn't it? It does. This is where we started. Okay, I wasn't sure if we were going to get back or not. There's one full of. I thought there was one here full of flour. Anyway, this is how we came in. Let's do the level up. So, let's go to stamina. And what does it take to get our bow a little bit stronger? And or sneak. We hit 40. So we qualify to get up in here now. 31 archery. Ah, eagle eye. That is so handy. Let's go there. It doesn't give us any more power, but allows us to see better. Power shot will help. Steady hand will help too. What does that do? Okay. This one, zooming in with a bow, slows down time. Ah, it's even more powerful. Okay. So now, we can, what, right click? Yeah, hold your breath and zoom in a little bit. For a little bit, and it takes away your stamina while you're doing it. The green bar goes down. Which is where you want to have then built up your stamina. So there are other uses for stamina other than just carry weight. All right, well, we've cleared all this out. And we are low on trusty arrows. And we're probably coming out late at night, 1:45 a.m. Ooh, vampire time. You know, vampires, they're almost overpowered. I've come across them in the past. They've almost always killed me. So, wondering if we do this series again, if I'm going to turn that DLC off. Don't know that it really adds much to the Skyrim experience. I'll have to think about that. Just in case I'm walking into a trap. Steel arrows. Okay, well, the hair is not stood up on the back of my neck, so we should be okay here. So this one is done. We've avenged these folks who were just trying to make a settlement here. We've got, I think, two petty soul gems left for things like sheep, or wolves, or what have you. But at any point here, I could be spotted by a vampire or a hellhound. I am not liking that. So let's take this smart. We're going to go that way. I'm going to do it. There's a fox over there, so nothing bad is in that direction. I'm going to peek over this way first. Looks clear. We're good out there. Giant's over there. I don't know what that is, but that looks like maybe the smoke from his fire. Fox running down there. What chased the fox? Nothing's chasing him, so maybe he spotted me. Okay, it's not looking like there's anything immediately nearby. Let's go ahead and around this corner. Can't really go high here. I'm kind of cornered. It's kind of an ambush area here. So I wanted to get a peek first. I've played this a few times before I recorded this series. There are a couple times I had to stop and catch myself trying to remember if something I had done was part of those playthroughs or part of this playthrough. Looks like there's something in the road right there. Something dark. Something big. Like a horse, kind of big. Or a bear. What is that? And yeah, there's something there. And one of them, as I were very early into it, first night, seemed like, walking around through the night, and what is that? And, oh, it's just ferns. Okay, shadows. Three vampires came out of nowhere, started yelling, and they were going to kill me. It was all I could do to get away. My level one character, I don't think I even had a bow. Now, what is that guy's story, and do I want to deal with it in the dark? Not particularly, but that is kind of what we're here for. I don't dare to shoot him, though. That's where you get into the, you know, that fine line of wanting to play a good character, but you lose the advantage taking somebody out that I've got by not, you know, by doing it while I'm not seen. Detected. Okay. It wasn't enough for him to truly detect me to know whether he's friend or foe. What is that right there? That looks like a saber cat. A dead saber cat. I think I know who this is. He's someone who wants to die a valiant death and wants someone to give it to him. I don't really want to be the one to give it to him. I think that's what this is about. One thing about playing this game so many hours is not a whole lot of surprises left, unfortunately. I'll go ahead and pop out of this mode and walk up and say hi. Maybe the last hello I ever say. Turn around. Okay, you don't seem to be freaking out here.
I am waiting for a good death.
Yeah. Why do you wish to die?
My time has come. I am old. Too old to become chief. It would be wrong for me to take wives at this age. So I will die. Malekith has given me a vision of a glorious death. I am to wait here until it finds me. As you can see, it has not yet arrived.
Mm-hmm. So no retirement plans with the orcs, huh? You don't look that old to me. Certainly you're still a strong, capable warrior. Sure.
Indeed. One should find his death while he can still call himself a proper man. We orc men are not like these Nords and Imperials who carry on until they are gray and feeble and their hair falls out. To cling to something past its usefulness is unseemly. How much more so when that thing is you?
I'm just going to pull out this way.
You should leave.
Yes,
I
should.
I don't want you scaring off my good death.
Okay. If I choose the wrong one, I'm committed to it. That's not what I was going to spend the rest of this evening, or rest of this episode doing. You know, dying myself. An old orc is still a powerful enemy. I'd love to see some vampires roll across his pathway and see who gives who a good death. I have a feeling the orc would win. There's a log just beckoning to be walked across. I've done that before. I'm trying to think what's at the other end. There is something at the other end. There's a reason to walk across that log. What's up here? Nothing in the road. Where are we now? The thought was to go to Uttering... I've gone... No, up there. Okay. Yeah, we're winding our way up to this area next. And then on up to Windhelm. Could call that an episode, then head into here. Then maybe work our way down to Riften. That might be something to do. Could peek into that prison that we started at. It's not on the map, is it? I thought we would have discovered it. We need to get that on the map. Let's be able to see our beginning. Deer running that way, or not deer, goat or sheep. Goats running that way, two of them. No idea what triggered that. That's the way we gotta go. Okay. And we still have that treasure map. So Riften is that way. Alright, we're going this way. But we are doing it up here. Can I go this steep? Not really. There we go. Yep, there we go. So who's out here? Seems like it's always around 3 in the morning when I get hit by them. 4:30. We may have passed the window of death for today. Got these guys. And we've got the skill to take a couple of them out now. Though not going to do as much good. What do we have in the way of carry weight left? Still not even halfway. What do we have in the way of arrows left? Okay, I'm buying well over 100 arrows next time. Of course, I'm heading to Windhelm. It's not easy to find sellers there, merchants. Not as plentiful. I think there's more in Whiterun than all of Windhelm. I could fill a soul gem, but I think I will wait for a wolf or something. Still nobody on the road. Now, this bridge has nothing to do with that map. There's no sign saying Riften. And there's no three-tiered waterfall. Okay. Alright, we have a long road down there. That could be plagued with someone wanting to end us. What's down there? There is something standing in the road over there. Another dark line right there. Yep, that's someone walking. I can't tell if the other one's walking or if that's just a few dark cobblestones in a row forming a line. Don't see a black hellhound, though, with them. That helps. Could it be a courier? That's a possibility. Standing in the shadows, though. Let's go up that hill right there. Gonna look over. Get a sense of what's going on. Detected by... It's the courier. No? Yes?
I've been looking for you.
Yes.
Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
boy.
Let's see here. Ah, a letter from the Jarl. Moving up in the world, eh? Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Gotta say, I'm impressed. Better than the U.S. Post Office. These guys will run around the woods at 4 in the morning trying to get a letter to you. All right. I am guessing that is the letter from Falkreath. Yeah, Sidgir. Boy, he likes himself. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Sidgir, and I have the honor to be the Jarl of the proud and ancient city of Falkreath. The fame of your exploits across Skyrim has brought you to my attention. Really? If you are interested in becoming a Thane of Falkreath Hold, I invite you to speak to me the next time you're in Falkreath. Aside from the honor that accrues to the title, my Thanes are entitled to a personal housecarl. I also can tell you privately that a choice parcel of land in Falkreath would be available for your purchase should your services prove useful to me. I look forward to meeting you in person. I remain. You're all Sidgir of Falkreath. Okay. And that's part of... Oh, what was the final DLC to this game? Something like Hearthstone or Hearthfire? Hearthfire? That allows you to buy property and build a house. And that's fun. I've done that a couple of times. I think I've grabbed all three plots at one time or another. And just to see what the, how the houses are different. Alright, we've been here before. He was the scary person in the road. Are there any other scary persons in the road? There's one more. What are you up to? And still no hellhound with you, though they don't always come with them. Though there's a hell goat right there. There's another one there. Alright, what's across the way? We came from that side before and looked down at this place. Yeah. And had we? No, we hadn't. It was a previous playthrough, I think, where I discovered that cave. I don't think we did. Bunch of spiders in there. Which gives you the spider venom that you need to... Where? Did I pass him? That you need to darken the leather to make black leather pouches. What was that noise? Oh. 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 Not good. Not good. Yeah, you just follow me, okay? Come on over. I'm going up on this rock. So you get close enough for me to shoot you from a distance, right? Can you get me? Yeah, I think I'm going to take you on face to face. Oh, come on. As soon as... Ah, dodged it. Oh, balance, balance, balance. Okay, three. Don't know if I'll be able to grab them, though. I grabbed him into something. Whoa. Saber cat. What did we get there? I probably went into a petty, huh? No? That was a common. Oh, lesser went into a common, so it will go uphill. It will not go downhill. Okay. Still, that was impressive. And when I saw him coming, now I saw a person. So he probably killed that person. I thought I heard a yell, too. Have that arrow back? No. Okay, set you for 4. And R. Those were worth 2. Yeah, you took out this person. Who were you? You were a farmer. Too bad. Well, I'll grab that from you. Okay. So, how long have I been playing this? I did not glance at my clock. The game's not stuttering, but it feels right. It feels like we're getting close to that 1 hour point. What are you? You're a good size. Wolf? I think wolf. Yeah, let's fill up a petty. There's two of them there. Three of them there. Ah, shot between them. Ooh, got him? Alright, I took a bite in the hand that time, but got blood in my eye. Ah! Okay. Alright, well. Why can't I eat you? There we are. No? Oh, you're gonna be there. Alright. Let's grab the other two. You? Yeah. That middle one, I didn't think I hit him. I think the game was a little bit lenient there. And that fills up all of those. I didn't actually think I had that many. So are we done with soul gems? Except for the common? No, we have the common. And we have two petties left. Two petties yet. Okay. So let's head into Windhelm and call this one done. I think I was saying it felt like I was getting close to that 1 hour mark. Now, an hour is not what I was really wanting to do episodes much anymore, but this series just feels right at that. Just want to curl up and watch this for a while rather than take it in little bites, you know, 20-30 minutes at a time. Oh, hello. You scared me more than I scared you. But Windhelm is not far from here. And then perhaps I will go and sell things off camera. You've seen enough of that already. And where? And kind of get ready for, what is it? Where is it? This is weird. So it's not back here. Was it above me the whole time? Is it out here? We're changing colors here. What is with the sky right now? Oh, this is morning. We walked all night, huh? Yeah, 7:30 in the morning. Okay. But it's so yellow. Is that really a sunrise, or are we getting into a snowstorm about to hit? What saw me? Now, I have had assassins come at me before that were invisible. Like they had some kind of a cloak or, you know, invisibility potion on. All you saw was a little blur. I'm not seeing the blur. I can't really go up. I bet you I can over here, though. I want to see what it is. I'm starting to notice the lag, though. I think I'm hitting my hour point. I am. Not let me. No. One more try. There we go. Just be persistent. Nothing there. There we go. And it can see me here. Oh, this is creepy. Is it above me? Or maybe it can hear me. That's possible too. What is out here? Don't fall off. Okay, we've got a banner here. Something is out here. There. Oh, I know who that is. That's, no, not you. Trying to get my... There we go. I'm going to put that away and try to get out of this. Okay. That's what I want to do. That is... Oh, what is his name? He's friendly. He's not gonna harm. Maik, the liar.
Maik wishes you well.
Normally what he says is is the opposite.
Once Maik got in trouble in Riften and fled to Windhelm, it is good that nobody there cared.
Well, those were not lies. Oh well. Anyway, sometimes he tells some pretty tall tales. I'm hoping he was the one that could see me and that the road is actually down here. It's not. Got me all turned around. Let's go up this way. So it must have been him, and it must be that he could hear me rather than see me. But what is with this? Ah, this is that. Okay. Road's down here. He's going to detect me the whole way, isn't he? Alright, let's get down here and around the corner. His back must be to me right now. Alright, well, there's Windhelm. So, wrap this episode up. Nothing down there. There's a wolf. They were here when we... in episode 1, I believe. We'll just let them be. We've done that before. There's the wind. Cold sounding wind. Up the snowdrift is a road. That is really strange. That these two don't seem to connect. Maybe it is supposed to be a snowdrift. I don't know. But I'm thinking I'm going to call this done right about here. So, we've been in the entrance of Windhelm before. I think I'm going to head in and sell everything off. Assuming this person walking toward me doesn't kill me right after I sign off here. And I will catch you next time, folks. This has been Njobl Ulram-blr. Bye-bye.